Loopfish fan. As you can see, I've now up and running. I am still re-scaping the tank. I put a filter in here. I put it upside down, as you can see. This is why I did it. I have a lot of debris floating around on the surface. So I thought, what can I do to make a surface skimmer? So that's basically a filter upside down. You have the slots on top of the water, sucking everything in. It's making your water, you know, pretty clear. It's now running for 5 or 10 minutes or so. And it's already way looking better. And you can hear a little bit of the pump. But yeah, that's not too bad, not too bad. Medium coarse, medium, very coarse, very coarse. Those ones I cut perfect. And yeah, I messed that one up, unfortunately. I siliconed that in place, so it goes on top and unfortunately, you can see it now from the side and it goes up. I put the pump between some rocks. I have a sand bed over here. That was my largest plant, but apparently it was two plants growing next to each other. So that is this one. And that was the other one. So this is the largest now from the three plants. I thought that piece was just one plant, but no, that's why it was so big. And it's already getting another offshoot. Maybe I removed that. So he's still taking plants out of this tank. I put this one over here. And you cannot see it. There are three plants in the back. You can see a tiny bit over there. Three plants, but yeah, it needs to run a little bit. And then I can aquascape again. So I have a cave over there, cave over there. I don't know what I'm going to do with that one. I have another one. I bought also today this cave. So one away one that I had. It's plastic. And I found this was some cave and it's made of stone. Pretty cool. So I need to put that in. And hopefully I have now my fish in this 90 liter tub. Unfortunately, marijuana jumped out once. And I put it back in, hopefully it's okay. I have the pump also running on that system, the heater. So hopefully the fish are okay. Yeah, a lot of water leaves I cut away. It's just not as beautiful. I need to cut this leaf away. I need to remove a couple of leaves. But also put it in the water, it starts to dry out. So yeah, that's what I'm trying to do. So chamber 1, chamber 2, 3, 4, and a return. Unfortunately, is this perfect? If this filter gets clogged up,
just overflows a little bit, and then into this chamber, this is clogged, and it flows over it. But yeah, I messed this one up. Can still overflow over here, but needs to fill up a lot, and then... Yeah, it looks pretty good. Hopefully it keeps on running for a long time. Better than that YAM filter. It drives me insane. So yeah, that's it for now. My timer and kaput on a couple of other things in it if you want. I don't know what I'm going to do with the heater, put it in here, but it's not just perfect. Or I can cut out of the bottom of each filter and put it on the bottom. I don't know. But for now I'm going to put it, I think, over here. And I don't need to forget to unplug it when I do a water change. I forget it every time. Yeah, I thought that this pump was broken. Sometimes it works perfect, and sometimes it has a little problems. It's starting up. But very good pump. That was my fault. Yeah, it's a big mess over here. I need to put sand in, still a lot of gravel, stones. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and thanks for all your awesome comments on my videos. Oh, I use now this pump. You can turn it up or turn it down with a lever. I have now fully open. I don't know if you can see it. That's the outflow. I need to raise this side a little bit up, because you can put your hand under it. I want total flush, and then goes in the back to the tank. So I need to put plank under it. But yeah, thanks for all your awesome comments. It's super awesome. And thanks for watching my videos. I appreciate it a whole lot. And until next time, have an awesome fish day. And goodbye.